So the two tax sales that occur in Cook County, one sale is the annual sale, right? Which is when you're unable to pay your taxes, the county then goes out to the private market and says, there's a difference between what we billed and what was collected. Will you lend us money to make up that gap, right? And what you get in exchange for that money of fronting those taxes is you get a certificate that gives you the right to acquire this property if the owner fails to pay the taxes, right? So that's the tax sale, that's the annual sale. So it is last year's, it's the gap on last year's taxes of unpaid taxes. Now, as an investor, you're motivated to do that if you think that either the price of redemption, the probability of redemption is high, because you also are getting paid interest in addition to the return of your of investment. You're also getting interest at the tune of about 1.5% a month. Okay, so that also accrues to you. So if the redemption period is 2.5 years, then you could receive up to a 30% return of your investment in going through and doing that. So for a lot of those tax buyers, that's a very attractive way to make money. And then the downside is that if the property, you know, isn't redeemed, the taxes aren't redeemed, then you have the ability, but not the obligation, to be able to obtain that property. That's the annual sale. But there are properties that get passed over the annual sale for the opposite reason. Either the redemption, the probability of redemption is low in the eyes of the investors, or the value as they see it is low relative to the amount of taxes that are owed. So in that situation, those buyers pass over those taxes, don't buy those taxes. And if that happens at least 3 times, then that group of property falls to what's called the scavenger sale. And so at the scavenger sale, it takes place every 2 years. And it's an auction, but it's an auction in which the option to acquire the property is what's being auctioned off. So as for the annual sale, you're bidding on the taxes owed. So my taxes are $5,000. Your bid is $5,000. And what you're putting in for is an interest bid. So it starts at 18%, goes down to zero. And so that will be in addition to, that will be a premium above and beyond the statutory interest that you would receive, right? Which is a month and a point and a half. So typically you'll see those things just bid down to zero. And then it becomes a lottery of all the people who are willing to take that zero bid. At the scavenger sale, it starts at $250 as the minimum bid and can go up even beyond the price of the tax. And what you're bidding is for the option to be able to take that property to deed. So in theory, what it allows you to do is to be able to acquire a property at a discount to its value. That's in theory. The reality of it in terms of how the sale is used, it's a risk-free speculation play for these buyers. They can go in, put 250 certificates options on properties, and if the area doesn't improve, if the dynamics, if the market fundamentals aren't there, there's ways in which they can then get their money back, their full 250 back, if it doesn't work out. And if it does work, then they're going to make, you know, tons of money in terms of their ability to be able to acquire that property and to make it work. What we do at the land bank is we go in as an active bidder there, because whereas the tax buyers at the scavenger sale are looking to speculate and see if something breaks, we're looking to actually make the market. So when we are able to acquire these properties, the property tax code allows us as an agency of the county to acquire the property, take it to deed, wipe out all the back taxes. That means not just back taxes, we're able to wipe out old mortgages, mechanics liens, municipal liens, so demolition liens, and liens for not cutting the grass, we can wipe all those out. And in some cases, even federal tax liens, depending on when it was filed. So we're able to really clear title. And in our ability to clear title, we can now reset these properties. So now that the fundamentals, I have a different look. So if I have a property, and let's say I think the property is only worth, you know, 20 grand, and the taxes outstanding are 10 grand, but I'm never going to buy those taxes as a tax buyer, even at a great discount that the scavenger sale offers. But if the land bank comes in and acquires that property and wipes that out, and the back taxes are gone, but also all the other stuff that it was on title was gone. Now that property is something that you can now consider for investment. And so that's what we're doing, really trying to reset properties. And as it turns out, 80% of all the properties that we see in Cook County that are in the scavenger sale are in the Black community. And so as you drive around, you see all the vacant lots and all the vacant buildings. Part of the issue around why they're not being redeveloped is because they're buried behind this wall of back taxes and code violations and other things that, as an investor, these things are just very unattractive. You're not going to go in and try and clear all that out and spend that money before you even get to the redevelopment dollars that's needed to bring it back. So by clearing out those other obstacles, it really does open up a universe of investment that could come into these neighborhoods and make a difference.
Yeah, those obstacles make it impossible for a seller to sell sometimes. So I've been offered properties free. Here, right. Please take this over. But there's two Daly Center court cases on it. There's 10,000 in water bills, and which makes it then I still got to put 80,000 into it, which it makes it impossible. And you're able to come in, the land bank's able to come in, wipe all that out, free and clear title, where now it just becomes a repair or an updating construction project versus
right.